I really do think it's been a long gestation period. Just probably thinking about things like this my whole life. But I've always been attracted to both science fiction and surrealism at the same time. But computers are always this thing that like you had to do inside the computer. So it's one of those notions that when you grow up, you're like, it's a question like, wouldn't it be cool if you could have computing spill outside the computer? Almost like an art project. I think Magically Brilliant did start out like an art project first, and then it turned out like maybe there's some science behind this, we could turn into something real, and it turned out there was. We were on a road trip to Austin, I think it was 2010 or 2011, and I think part of Magically got born on that road trip, and I took a few weeks off to go, I'd go with my band to play at South By, and I was like, I'm going to do something else. I sort of knew that. And it was like, maybe this Magic Leap thing is worth giving a shot.
Magic, to me, means an experience that you can't explain. It takes a long time for you to say, oh, I know that that happens. And it's so incredible that you say, I don't know how that happened, but give me some more of that.
And, it is very wild, because it's an idea that started out, like, in my little garage. I have a garage studio, and there's a little thing painted, says Magic Leap Studios, like hand-painted on it. And like that was the pretty humble origin. So it is very surreal what Magic Leap is still becoming, but it is very wild feeling, especially when you reflect on where you are at day zero. I think if the team saw what they're doing today and you went back in time, they wouldn't believe they could do it. It shows you the power of collective brain power. When people believe they can do something, they can really make something happen.